New Zealand honey is one of our most prized exports, but most of the headlines are dominated by Manuka, Manuka, Manuka.
One couple in the Chatham Islands is creating a honey product unlike anything you've ever seen before. Here's Lucas de Jong.
They're the flavours these islands are famous for.
The Chatham Island blue cod, that is the favourite. And then the crayfish, power.
But tonight, the blue cod ceviche is paired with a new local hero.
And then I'm going to sprinkle a bit of the honey.
Freeze-dried honey.
So they say it's like candy floss. It's been called a honey cloud.
It's an idea that Kai had when trying to show off her island's flavours.
I wanted something to stand against or rise above with the champions that are here.
Well, I wasn't surprised because she always comes home with this kind of ideas.
Together with her partner Fran.
She's the brains, I'm the brawn.
They've created Go Wild, freeze-dried Chatham Island honey that is unlike anything else in the world.
What makes it special, Kai? Yeah.
Oh, well, the 80 million years of isolation.
That's a nice ingredient.
And she's not joking. The bees here are some of the healthiest disease-free honey makers in the world.
The bees here don't have varroa, they don't have AFB.
And that means no nasty chemicals.
Products being sent overseas are being tested for insecticides, pesticides. We don't have any.
And according to Mana,
the drones that these bees produce, the motility of their sperm, the viability of the sperm, is very high.
Man, I didn't know we were going in this direction. Okay.
Drones from here are the full McCoy.
But randy yet clean bees still need nectar. And again, the Chatham Islands has something special.
There are 44 species of plant here that are found nowhere else in the world.
Fran and Kai have worked with Unitech ecologist Peter DeLange to create a 7-acre native sanctuary.
Needed someone to give value.
These are the three that make really good honey on this island. See, this one is Tarahinau. They have those bell-like flowers, little star-like flowers. This is Pōteriteri, very common shrub. You can see it all through here. And then the last one hasn't really got a common name. We could call it Mingi Mingi. Produces a tremendous amount of honey. And this one flowers now when there's not a lot in flower, so it's very important for bees.
Their hope. As demand for their product grows, other locals will embrace endemic planting and create their own little havens across the archipelago.
And you're going to be doing the environment a wonderful thing because you're planting endemic species only found on the Chathams, but you're going to benefit too because you're going to get a honey that's unique to this place.
It's a ruby red when you first extract it.
The end result is the prized Tarahina honey.
Strong smell.
That's strong smell.
And sticky.
Yeah, good for cooking.
Fran and Kai now show visitors around their land to share its story.
A lot of people wanted to see where the honey came from and the plant species, so it's more about educating at least one tourist or every tourist that comes through.
Educating them about a flower, bee and honey that's found nowhere else on Earth.
Cheers, Kai. Thank you. Beautiful.
Beautiful, yes, exactly.
Beautiful pictures. Doesn't the flora look interesting on the chats?
Well, it does. What is interesting is this, freeze-dried honey. And it really does taste like candy floss. I could actually probably... We're doing a lot, I'm sorry. I know it's triggering for a lot of people watching us eat on the show.
Yeah.
But it's a great product.
Really does taste like candy
floss. We're just trying
to get it. Insane prices for our honey internationally as well. And New Zealand Manuka honey, of course, recently. Some sold in Harrods, in the department store in London, for $2,700 New Zealand dollars.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Do you think you get the same health benefits if you just went up to a Manuka tree and, like, licked the blossoms? Would that...
Would you like to try that? I wouldn't.